Hello friends, today we are going to study different parts of swing machine needle and their functions in detail. So the swing machine is one of the most important piece of equipment in the ready-made garment industry. As we have to see different types of swing machines in detail, we need to study the different parts of swing machine needle in detail and their functions. So, we are going to study different parts of swing machine needle and their functions. So, this is the image to show. This is a diagram of the swing machine needle. The first part is butt, the tapering part, upper part, then the shoulder, then the blade, scarf, and then the point. This is the other side of the needle, which shows shank, long groove, short groove, eye, and point. These are the enlisted parts of the needle. So we will study these in the detail. The first is butt. Butt is the upper part, tapering predetermined shape, which is attached to the clamp, with the clamp to the needle bar, which helps in the swing. Then there's a shank. Shank is the bottom part of the swing needle, which is tied in the needle bar. It may be flat or cylindrical on one side, because one side it is flat and on the other side it is cylindrical. Shank is wider than the remaining parts of the needle, because it is the upper part, it is as wider as the needle bar where it has to be attached. It works as the support of the needle. Then we have the shoulder. The shoulder is the area between the shank and the blade, from which the needle penetrates through the fabric to reach its lowest position. Then the shoulder also penetrates through the fabric, as it helps to reduce the friction between fabric and needle. Then is the blade. The blade is a part from needle eye to shoulder. It is the longest part of the needle, and maximum friction with fabric takes place in this area. The blade is gradually tapered to the tip. Then we have long groove. A long groove is a long and thin groove in the blade from shoulder to needle eye. Swing thread takes place in the groove during up and down of the swing machine needle when the needle bar goes up and down, and it helps to reduce the friction between needle, fabric, and swing thread. There is a lower possibility of damaging thread due to friction. Then we have short groove. A short groove is placed on the side of the needle where the hook or the loop is placed. It is a small groove between the tip and the needle eye. A short groove helps the swing thread to create a loop in the fabric. Then we have needle eye. A needle eye is a small eye from which we have to keep the thread inside the needle. The needle eye holds the needle thread, and it also helps to create a loop. The inside edge of the needle eye is most important, especially when the needle passes through the fabric, because there is possibility of damaging the thread. Then we have scarf. The scarf is a curved slot near the eye. It helps to close the setting between the loop and the needle. As a result, it is easy to catch the needle loop by the hook or looper. Second last, we have point. Point is a part from the needle eye to the tip. It helps to penetrate the needle into the fabric without any damaging, as it will not fray the fabric. Then we have tip. The ending edge of the needle is called the tip. Tip helps to penetrate the needle into the fabric without any damages. It helps to create holes in the fabric during the swing of the garment.